Hello! Another month brings another set of updates for Hyper-Converged Infrastructure in Windows Admin Center. Here's what's new in the June update. The first thing you'll notice is the reorganized navigation menu on the left-hand side. Related tools are now organized into groups. For example, volumes and drives together as storage, instead of in one big alphabetical list. This lays the groundwork for some new tools that will appear in the coming months. Speaking of new tools, the June update introduces software-defined networking, for the first time, integrated seamlessly into the hyper-converged cluster connection. When you add the cluster, simply check the box to configure the network controller and provide its URI. In the Virtual Networks tool, you can browse and manage virtual networks and virtual subnets. You can create a new virtual network with one or multiple address prefixes and subnets. Later, you can add another subnet, or configure or remove an existing one, all within Windows Admin Center, with common sense validation to help you get things right on the first try. Connecting virtual machines to virtual networks is also easy, integrated directly into the Virtual Machines tool. In the New Virtual Machine pane, you can choose the virtual network and virtual subnet to join, or you can also do so in the VM settings, under Networks. The June update also introduces all new views to monitor your SDN infrastructure. Quickly assess the status, alerts, and performance of your software-defined networking, and drill in for detailed information about your network controllers, software load balancers, and gateways, such as properties, pools of public or private IPs, resource consumption of infrastructure VMs, and much more. All this functionality for software-defined networking is available for both Windows Server 2016 and the insider preview of Windows Server 2019, so you can try it out today. Lastly, there are many more usability improvements throughout the hyper-converged cluster connection. For example, groups in the inventory grid now show how many items they contain. Volume actions appear directly at the top, so you can delete a volume, then delete another one, and another one, all without navigating. And, based on your feedback, we've added an IOPS column, so you can easily tell which volumes are the active ones. Okay, that's a quick look at what's new in the June update of Windows Admin Center for hyper-converged infrastructure. To try it out, install the latest cumulative update of Windows Server 2016 or the insider preview of Windows Server 2019 and download Windows Admin Center. Let us know what you think. Thanks, and see you next month.